Good morning, fans of PrivateerFX. Coming at you on Thursday here, PPI day today. Quiet day yesterday. We got paid in euro sterling, so then we just kind of shut things down a bit. Didn't really do a whole heck of a lot. Yields higher yesterday, but also stocks held up, right? Fairly robust response to a pretty hot retail sales. So it was a little tricky. You know, Aussie on its knees, 68.60, and then back up a percent. A lot of retracements yesterday. So tricky day. We got paid early with that euro sterling with those UK numbers, although we tried to get cute at 88.50. And so we did leave some money on the table as it traded all the way up to 95. But c'est la vie. Let's be more forward-looking and talk about today. We got PPI today at 2:30. Got a bunch of Fed speakers. I don't think it's super important. We had Aussie employment last night. That looks like it came in weaker just based on the Aussie price action. Yeah, minus 11. Looking for plus 19. Let's look at Aussie. It's weird. That's a big miss in employment. So yeah, here's Aussie here, 69.11. This is the employment hour, down to 70. And immediately back up to 16. I guess this is trading more in line with global risk than it is with the local global macro factors. Obviously, equities are higher, 41.65. This is getting into the sell zone. Anywhere between 86 and 06 in equities, we're going to sell today. Dollar yen, I don't know. Rates are higher. This should be supportive. It's just flopping around, right? All the way up to 134.36, down to 133.64. No idea. Just flopping around. It could be confirmation of the new BOJ governor moving that a little bit. But in general, it's just not really. It's just going nowhere fast. This should be supportive today, 133.50. Down to 133.50.30 should be support. But of course, do you really want to go into PPI with a big packet of dollars on? I don't think so. So just be wary of that. Let's look at some technical patterns. Sterling Swiss. Got a lot of lows here. 110.56. These are all 110.85. Typically not your best technically trading pair. Sterling Swiss. But I just wanted to point it out. We're not going to trade it. But if this was something a little bit more frisky, we would consider trading this level here. 110.80. If you still have long euro sterling, if this thing sort of tilts down there, you could see some more extension. It's just something to watch today, especially if you're either going to scoop up some euro sterling on some low ones, or if you're still long from yesterday. If you are, you're a better man than me. Keep an eye on that sterling Swiss level. Dollar Swiss, we're just going to mention it because we want it on the frontal lobe when this does come into play, 92.90. We keep talking about it. It seems very far away, but we're just going to keep it on the frontal lobe. Euro also and Aussie now have sort of important lows in. So 106.60, very, very important level in Euro. Below this, you can see this thing down to 105, and now Aussie also 68.60. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lows right around this level. This is obviously, it looks like a little bit of a head and shoulders. The market will be watching this level, these obvious patterns. whether you believe in technical analysis or not, I don't actually care. You just have to be able to pick out patterns that people will be watching and will be trading. So you can be pretty sure people are going to be selling. The conservative guys are going to be selling through this low, 68.55. But anywhere down below 68.60, there's going to be some forced selling for people who are trading this technical pattern. What else? Dollar CAD. We got some BOC guys talking today, but nobody cares. CAD has just died a death. Not much going on there. Aussie yen. This was it. In play at the fix, but not much going on there. That's just trading with Aussie. Dollars are. $18.09.86. Double top up here. This may retrace lower now, especially if stocks remain sort of ebullient. This could turn and head lower. Let's also look at dollar max. This 1850 level is important. It's been kind of jerking around in a sort of like kind of tease through 50 and then back higher yesterday, tease through down to, what was that, a little 48.36. Traded all the way back up to 75. I like this level here. If PPI comes in soft, we're going to sell dollar MEX through 1850. Sinaloa cartel, be what it may. We like this level. Keep an eye, 1850. This is an important one. Gold, not doing much. Still hanging out down through 1850. Maybe down to 1830 there. Nothing to do in gold. You may want to try and buy some stretchies down at 1800. Patience. Going into today's open. It's still early, right? It's 4:48 a.m. in the UK. 5:48 here in Switzerland. So we got a couple hours before Europe comes in. If this Aussie keeps creeping higher, we're gonna fade this a little bit, maybe up between 30 and 50. This doesn't make a ton of sense for us, and those employment numbers were atrocious. So this is on the frontal lobe here for the open. We're watching dollar max. That's a trade for North American time zone. We don't usually trade that in Europe. And then if we do happen to get low ones in euro sterling, we're going to rebuy that down at 88.50. That's all we got for you guys today. I wish you good luck and good profits out there. Catch you tomorrow.